Hey, all right. Yeah, welcome to the divine rapture that is the Corpse Paint Show. I've got a little rant here, guys, and then we'll get on to a bunch of good stuff. But, you know, look, I was reading an interesting article today. It's about smaller is better, and it makes me think the underground is better. Our show is the underground. I feel also that live friends that you meet or speak to on the phone are better than fake bots. Janie Slash and I like to go to smaller towns when we go and have fun on vacation. We've been recently to Eureka Springs, Arkansas, Natchitoches, Louisiana. We love Jefferson, Texas. We love Marfa, Texas. And then the bands we have that have been in the studio and on our show, Crop Dust, Responsible Johnny, Silver Tongue Devil, Interment. These are local Dallas metal bands. Chemicost, Skull Archer, Electric Vengeance, Epic Death, Scary Cheering, The Bang Bangs, The Infamous. And then bands from across the globe that have created some outstanding vinyl releases that are really under the radar that have been guests on this show. Demonos, Cadaveria, The Bell Rays, The Vibrators, Curse the Fall, Electric Wizard, Vicky Vortex, and The Cum Shots, Indefilade, The Darts, Nunslaughter, Crest of Darkness, Necro Delirium, De Profundis, Archeron, Midnight, Sisters of Suffocation, Bisto Blanco, Wormrot, Gabriel and the Apocalypse, Shadow Flag, Venomous Maximus, Meat Train, Smother Bowels, Shooter, Asheron, and others. I'm probably forgetting, I apologize. Our local friends and our local band friends have about 1,000 or so likes on Facebook. I like that. When I see someone who has 500,000 likes on Facebook, I think to myself, they don't really need my support. It's these local bands with maybe 1,000 that need my support. Here is what the corporate feeding frenzy of capitalism has wrought. A big article today in the New York Times regarding actors, pastors, models, comedians, TV stars, professional athletes who buy fake followers. They use fraud to make themselves puffed up and look bad. You're bad, ain't ya? And they name names. Luis Linton, Michael Dell, Ray Lewis, Kathy Ireland, John Leguizamo, Clay Aiken, plus the guy who wrote a secret book called Why Shame Sells. It's about marketing. His claim in this book is that the secret to influence is authenticity. What is my point? Authenticity is important. But not your fraudulent kind of authenticity. We like authenticity where you know your friends on your friend list. This is why I like the Satanic Temple. They're not actively trying to get new recruits. You know what I'm saying? If you don't like our show, that's fine. Don't like us. Don't follow us on Facebook. We're going to keep making interesting underground shows of interest to some. We're the grassroots. Maybe you could call it a niche. And let's be honest about movies. Would you rather watch some Disney-fied huge movie with a product placement and 17 accountants? Or would you rather watch Circus of the Dead or Grime Wave or I Am Virgin? Or One of the Dead. This is a freaking great movie, Mike.
Right on.
One of the Dead. And here's a movie about directors who make movies with no budget. It's a documentary called
That's pretty cool.
Penny Pinchers.
I just liked how you said, I am virgin with so much sincerity.
I am virgin.
Yeah. We all know that's a lie.
Do you feel good about yourself when you purchase $250,000 followers? Do you sleep at night? Do you represent your advertisers honestly? We feel smaller is better and local is great. And guess what? When I see that many followers, like I said, those people don't need my support. You know who needs my support? Crop Dust, local metal band. Electric Vengeance, these are two Dallas bands. They need my support. Or this band, Vile and Devoid. They put on a free show on Thursday at Brain Dead Brewing. And it was great.
How did I miss this?
And then I saw a title on one of the songs on their cassette called Soulless Destroyers of the Human Race. And I knew we were in line. We live in a time when you can use fraud to make yourself seem puffed up and important. How weak and pathetic are you, and lacking of confidence are you? Make your art, do your thing, and don't worry about how many followers. Do you really care? When humanity is lost, your art still endures. That's my point and my rant. And this article really struck me today in the Times about how many actors, authors, pastors, others buy numbers to make themselves look more important. And well, then they market themselves to their advertisers, business partners, you know, as having 500,000 followers and you know, they're bots.
Well, I think it, social media in general is a blatant gift to marketing firms on Madison Avenue, because not only are we providing what makes us tick internally and giving them quantifiable numbers that they can kind of act upon or simulate in your case, but it's to a point where it's even affecting how we think and what we buy and how we feel about ourselves. There's a really, really good book that I would love to let you borrow by William Davies called the Market of Happiness, or actually forgot what the, but it's basically about that, how we are giving all of this information about ourselves to package ourselves that we can be sold what makes us happy, that makes us sad, what makes us angry. And it's so easily manipulated. It's unbelievable.
And do you think a lot of people, and Raindrops, you let me know too, that you know that they're happy or unhappy based on how many numbers they see following them or liking them?
Yeah, definitely. So I know, taking that, I'm a part of a couple of these really small bands, very small, Burlesque Troupe and then the Vampire Court of Dallas. I mean, I know for me and Mike, when we see our numbers go up, it gives us a little tinge, like, oh, our names are getting out there. But you sometimes have to ask yourself, like, out of those quality of people that are following you, who actually is along the same lines and just as motivated as you are?
And what's superficial?
Yeah. So superficial definitely falls into that, which comes into, yeah, you may be getting these numbers, you may be getting this type of following, but how many people are coming to your shows? How many people are purchasing your gear? Really showing that true support besides being another name and number in the system.
And to apologize to Professor Davies real quick, it's The Happiness Industry. It was put out in 2010. It's a really, really
sure.
good book.
Yeah.
But in it, he describes how a lot of these people are posting the best of themselves online, and it's making everyone else anxious. There's
sure.
a positive
sure.
correlation.
Because they think everyone else has a great life. Because they only see the beach photos and the cruise, you know, photos or whatever, and they think everyone's life is great. Maybe mine isn't. I don't know. I think, my opinion, social media is maybe rotten to the core, and it could implode on itself. And I don't know. Maybe in a couple of years, we might be sitting here thinking, you know, why were we slaves to this system?
Yeah.
I think it's corporate America trying to brain control us, and I think smaller is better. Lesser numbers. I don't care. Unlike us right now. We have a core that follow this show. So what?
Yeah.
You want to add a few to it, take a few away, you know, whatever.
Well, it's,
but if you want to stay with the underground and learn a few cool things, then yeah, stay part of our family. Yeah,
absolutely. And it's to a point where it's starting to take the place of in-person interaction. Oh, why bother meeting you for a beer or something after the show when, hey, I can comment on your Facebook page.
Interesting.
While you drink that beer.
Could I put it to the test of anyone in this room? The friends you have on your Facebook page, have you actually talked to every single one of them by phone or eyeball to eyeball? Have you? You know, I don't know. I'm just posing that.
Well, I think the limit on Facebook is, what, 5,000
followers? I think it's 5,000 now, followers.
How on earth are you able to sit down and talk to 5,000 people on a regular basis?
Yeah. Which... there again, you're digging into the social media platform. It's easier to have, like, post a picture and connect to thousands of people versus having that genuine human effect of going to them in person and having that in-person communication. Yeah. Versus having a beer with one person, you can post a picture drinking this beer and 100, 200 people are going to comment on it.
Are you playing devil's advocate to Satan right now?
I am.
That's awesome.
I'm playing a little bit of a devil's advocate right now.
Look. I don't know. You remember in the 90s there was grunge, and then it seemed like the counterweight to that was Unplugged. You know, we had MTV Unplugged, and it was the mild version of everything. I don't know. Yeah. I think this is America, man. We go way over one way, and then a couple years later, we go way the other direction. I don't know. Is the other shoe going to fall on social media? I don't know. But a lot of people, man, live, breathe, and die and commit suicide based on numbers and things they see on social media. And I say, have some eyeball to eyeball or a real actual telephone call with your friends.
Amen, Satan.
Oh, okay. I got it. Hey, let me just point out that this wonderful underbed of music is our friend Cataveria. Look at her. She's from Italy.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Hello.
I love this band. And that is her name and also the name of the band. I like them a lot, so that's our little underbed. Hey, let's talk about some things, Mike.
Sorry.
All right. So I sent you a couple interesting links to articles, and I call them Satan in the News. And we're just going to try and connect some dots on a couple of things here that drive me crazy, that certain people do. And so, if possible, all right, let's start with this one. So this guy, Rick Wiles, he claims someone is building a brain that will embody Lucifer's mind. Now, okay. How do people get away with this?
Oh, using this right-wing watch. You know that's a credible source right there.
No, no, they are. They monitor the extreme preachers.
Oh, no.
Yeah. No. They're a good source. They monitor these extremists.
I gotcha.
Outlandish things like we're building Hitler's brain or whatever it is he's claiming.
Okay. So the source that they're pulling from is the issue. That's fair enough.
So Right Wing Watch is great. I recommend that you check it out.
Definitely. I appreciate it.
So basically, you know, I don't know, he's claiming somehow that leftists are getting together and building a mega Lucifer brain. I'm not saying this. It's these crazy preachers who are saying this, okay? All right.
If I only had a brain.
Sort of like that.
Well, I think it touches on a lot of fears, doesn't it? Not only that, one, you have kind of the machine aspect that everyone's afraid of. I think Raymond Kurzweil and his kind of machine singularity is touched upon, but I don't even know where to start here.
You know what's also really interesting? It can play on the fear, going back to your social media rant, is everyone wants to be correct. Everyone wants to have all the knowledge. Everyone wants to know everything. And to hear that this other brain's coming out, I guess it's a general fear of just not knowing.
It's ludicrous.
It is.
Okay.
Luciferous.
All right. Luciferous. All right. So we had another link. I'm trying to. All right. Yeah. All right. Here we go.
Okay.
All right. So here's the meat of it, Mike. This is what I want to get into with you. All right. So this evangelist on Roy Moore, lying is okay if it advances the kingdom of God.
Okay.
But the previous article, Rick Wiles, really goes into a big rant about if you're a Christian, you should not be lying about anything. And in fact, one of the Ten Commandments, etc., you know, not bearing false witness, etc.
Yeah.
But these other supporters of Roy Moore, in fact, indicate that, it is all right to lie if it helps our side. Okay.
Well, I think it's hearkening back to a lot of the, I think they, superheroes. I think that's the best example you can have. And trust me here. Let me go.
Okay.
There was an argument in philosophy, especially when kind of the whole blockbuster superhero movies were coming out. And it's an argument based upon, if you have a most supreme evil on the face of the planet, what extent are you going to go to eliminate that evil? Are you going to become evil yourself? And a lot of philosophers were tossing around that ball. And the issue is you're poisoning your own ideology if you're going onto that extent.
Sure. Yeah.
So it's how far are you willing to go to advance your own ideology, but at the same time you're poisoning it and poisoning the well for others. So it's like, you're kind of putting a bullet in your own cause at that point.
Yeah.
So it's
good point.
I feel like it could be double as toxic because if you're going to lie, I mean, how often do lies stay covered?
Yeah.
Especially in politicians and everything going on nowadays, it's going to be uncovered sooner or later. And it's just going to basically self-destruction.
I agree completely. And to circle back to buying fraudulent likes on your for your page is going to come back to haunt you. It is. And if you somehow embrace this sort of false foundation that you want to build your building on and not think it's going to crumble, you're crazy. But I point this out also to just expose the hypocrisy that is rampant.
And that's really what it is.
Among the religious right, when they when they say lying is okay, if it advances their cause.
Well, you have to think, too, a lot with evangelical religious right. To them, it's and I'm this is an unfair generalization to some, and I apologize if that's true, that it is a cosmic good versus evil. There is no gray areas. We will do whatever we can to eliminate this horrible evil that we believe poisons everything.
I feel like that's very oxymoronic because isn't, like, not to bash anybody out there or anything, but the Christian language is thou shalt not lie is one of their biggest things that they should be following back
how
on.
How far are you willing to go?
Now, how far are you
if you're
lie?
Willing to lie, are you willing to kill? Are you willing to commit genocide?
I feel like it just provides you stepping stones to be able to allow you to do things like that.
Yeah, that good versus evil mentality, that no gray area mentality is going to cause some very scary things if they start tainting politics more than they already have.
It's out there happening right now.
Oh, yeah. And do you really want a person that believes in this cosmic good versus evil battle with their hand hovering over the nuclear button?
Yeah.
I know. I know.
And you know what? You know what else, Mike, on that same line, Rain? There are a lot of Christian radio shows that say we're in the final days, the last days, the days of judgment, the whatever they call it. Now!
That they've been saying since the 1920s.
Oh, they've been saying that a long, long time. Okay. All right. But now they have a, I don't know, it seems like a louder voice or a farther reach. And so that being the case, you know, why would someone who is brainwashed like that even want to plan for the future or care if we press the nuclear button now, thinking, hey, man, you know.
Let's kickstart the apocalypse.
Let's kickstart it, man.
Yeah.
In fact, you know, moving Jerusalem to, you know, the as being in Israel, our destination of our offices now, you know, is another step they claim is in that.
I love the Palestinian response to that. Did you read that article at all?
Tell me.
In return for moving the capital of Israel or recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, meeting that kind of biblical specification, the Palestinian contingent in Jerusalem decided to say that Texas now belongs to Mexico.
Oh, good point.
Yes.
Because it used to be.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, it basically proves that, you know what, your recognition has no bearing on how we live our lives or go about our business. And as soon as I read that, I was like, okay, you guys get some points. Well played.
Oh, yeah.
Well played, gentlemen.
Hey, all right, so I did want to point out, too, a couple of cool events coming up. Now, we'll get to yours, of course. We will definitely talk about
it.
But first, there's this cool guy in town doing some sort of, like, guitar event. Yeah, this dude here. Okay, he looks like a professor. So what? It's fine. This is a guitar. It's a exhibit at the museum. Is Fort Worth Museum? All right, the instrument that rock the world, a brief history of the world's most popular instrument, and it is a museum exhibit about the guitar.
I guess
the acoustic and the electric guitar.
You should get a group together and go see that.
We should, yeah.
They really need to get a better picture for that. Like,
get off that social media.
Shredding.
We need like a picture of Dimebag or something. Not that dude. All right, but there was another link actually to that same. Yeah, there it is. That's a little bit better graphic.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
The instrument that rocked the world. Artist. So I imagine this is about more of the electric guitar. I'm not sure. But anyways, just looks kind of interesting. It's at Fort Worth Museum of History, and they always put on great things. So if you're in North Texas, man, Check it out. All right. So, can we go into a couple of movie previews?
Yeah. I'm excited for a bunch of really great movies.
Oh yeah, this is all. She's been pestering me to death. She's like, I want to go to this.
But we also have some music videos and a couple other things too. So I want to kind of scroll through look at all these, and then we'll definitely have time to talk about Bleeding Hearts Ball later. But let's see, I forgot which one we're starting with. It was either a music video or a trailer. The trailer, yeah, on that one, yeah. You gotta watch this rain.
Oh yeah? I think I've seen this preview.
I've gotta prepare you for this world.
Be a lamb and make your muff another drinky.
You know, son, the nail that sticks out gets hammered down.
I am being terrorized out there all day, every day.
Aren't you being overly dramatic?
Normally, I would take that as a compliment.
I just wanted to let you know that I think you're amazing.
I didn't mean to startle you.
I certainly did not mean to make that sound.
You're not supposed to feel.
You're supposed to be a man and do.
Your situation in school might get a whole lot better. Just tone it down a little.
Why did you stop wearing blue jeans?
I'm compromising myself for reasons I don't even understand.
I mean, you're not getting beamed in the head as much anymore.
What am I going to do with you?
I'm announcing my candidacy for homecoming queen!
How do you want to be identified? Gay, straight, transgender?
Gender obliviator?
Free!
Well, I was gonna reclaim it as my own anyway.
Are you serious?
You do what you want, but from now on your own. We dream away!
This is a simple case of decency versus depravity.
If life kicks you,
you just kick higher!
You can call me a freak, okay. You're all freaks, too. Is that what being a teenager is all about?
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
here comes Billy Bloom.
What's the F for?
It's for freak, you freak.
Stand up, sit down, fight, fight, fight.
All right, so yeah, look, we're a heavy show. We cover heavy topics, but I had to lighten it up with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's still a pretty heavy topic, though. I mean, come on, Bette Midler's in that.
Freak Show, he comes out in high school and all of the challenges that go with that and maybe some rewards that go with that, you know? And you know, didn't we all have challenges in high school just surviving? You
exactly.
know, and here's somebody who's really trying to identify who he is.
Yeah, no, that's a brilliant. I'm looking forward to it.
I appreciate his passion because I know myself. I was just the scary kid in the corner, just kind of making my own freak show by myself, not promoting it on anyone else.
That fucking soundtrack sounds amazing too.
Freak Show soundtrack?
Yeah.
What'd you hear?
What the kind of was it the not future pop, but kind of like a little bit of synth pop?
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I like that too. I guess I wasn't attuned to the music. You always are, man.
Oh, yeah.
That's the only reason I can get him to go see movies
the music's
with me.
In here, man.
It's got to have a good soundtrack.
No kidding.
Yeah. No, that's the only reason I can take him to movies, especially horror films. It's got to have a good soundtrack.
Gotcha. Yeah. All right. Well, good. Yeah. I like Witch House, Dark Waves, Synth Waves, all that good stuff. Dance rock, dance pop.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm definitely.
No dubstep, though, right?
Yeah, dubstep.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Satan's got moves.
Look. Hey.
I can see his being a dancer.
So I'm doing some DJ gigs.
Cool.
Yeah, starting with on the rooftop at Wits End. And so you got various themes. I'll tell you guys more about it, but
heck
it's
yeah,
DJ
man.
Satan. DJ Satan.
DJ Satan.
Man,
I like
would
it.
Not I'm have not. Guessed that.
Never. All right. I got more stuff to show you.
It would be like DJ 666 up in the house.
Now, the next one we got queued up is, I forgot. We're just going to roll to it. Oh, yeah. Okay. So I'm going to talk over it. This is our good friend, Kristeen Young. She is pleasantly insane. Just take a look for a second.
Yeah.
right. So we kind of fade that out. All right. The artist's name is Kristeen Young. Okay. I got a semi-crush on her. I do. I think she's fascinating. She's interesting. She's way left field. And I like everything about her. I do. She makes this crazy, insane noise that you can't sit still through. You know, just with piano, bass, drums, and occasional guitar. So Kristeen is going to be a guest on this show in 2 weeks. Kristeen Young. Here on our show, yes. Now,
could stay tuned for that one.
Can I mention also she's opening for The Damned? She is the opening act for The Damned in London for 2 dates coming up in February. So I don't know. Like her a lot. That's Kristeen Young.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And I've kind of noticed that about you. You tend to lean toward more of the different people and
off the beaten path.
Oh, yeah. No.
Yeah. Artists that need our support.
Yeah, and don't buy likes on Facebook.
Right. I don't like Metallica on Facebook. They don't need number 679,000 follower. And it's probably 10 million. I don't even know what it is. They don't need me. I like artists like Kristeen Young, who are sincere, grassroots, down to earth, make honest music that's not heavily overproduced and are in your face. You know? I don't know. Like it.
Yeah, just like our friends with like Psyche Corporation, like those are some really great people that are really small that are you people, like a lot of people don't even realize they exist, but will blow the tops off of anything.
Well, what do they do?
Like Psyche Corporation, from the music I've heard from her, she is a great student. And what she does is she takes kind of a classical approach, but takes it into a more industrial step.
Mm. It's kind of a mix of classical, operatic with synth pop and steampunk and future.
All right.
Almost like a cyber to some of her songs as well. It's kind of an insane mix of intelligence and art and creativity, and it's blown me away.
Yeah. What's your name again?
Psyche Corporation.
Cool.
We'll send you a link.
Yeah, please. Yeah,
fantastic.
Please. Yeah. Yeah. If she's got less than 1,000 followers, all the better.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so I think we have next queued up another music video or a trailer. No, this is interesting too. Watch This Rain. Tell me if you like it.
It's about witches.
Come on, Peter, let's go.
Mary, stop. Everyone knows you're not supposed to go into the woods on misty days.
I found it in the woods.
The witch's flower. They only bloom once every 7 years. They say witches used to seek it out.
What is going on? Tonight, I really am a witch.
This is Endor College, one of the most prestigious schools for witches.
How do you do, Miss Mary?
Amazing.
You're a once-in-a-century talent. A remarkable witch.
In this world, there exist certain powers that can never be harnessed. That girl has discovered where the flowers are.
This little flower will change the world.
Peter!
We have to go. Come on, Tib.
Away! You're going to be the subject of my most important magical experiment.
That girl could ruin everything.
I mustn't give up. I made a promise. We are going home together, all of us. Give me your...
That's called Raindrops and the Witch's Flower.
I feel like this really took me back to my Kiki delivery service.
The art is really similar. I'm really curious to know if they're linked with Studio Ghibli or Ghibli at all. Yeah, the people that made that originally.
It looks like they're a lot more deeper deeper side to everything, kind of kind of just saying I'm a witch, but kind of like showing the creation behind all of it too.
Yeah, and she's obviously out to do good and help. I don't know. I like that.
I mean, I can't judge someone that's got a black kitten with them.
No. Right. Or black rats.
Right.
So, yeah, speaking of that, we miss Janie Slash tonight, but she will be back next week to talk about Women in Horror Month, which is February every year. Women in Horror Month, so we'll talk about women in horror. Also, if you watch the Grammys tonight, which is, I don't know, to me, another corporate overblown blowhard fest, but we do want to give a, you know, hails and a fist pump to Code Orange, Pittsburgh metal band that's nominated for a metal category.
Nice.
So, yeah. Code Orange is really, really rocking right now, and it'd be cool if they win. All right. So we got another music video coming up, or maybe it's a trailer.
I'm excited.
Yeah. Let's take a look.
Spence is killing
me. Know.
And then
never
we
know.
Talk. Yeah. Let's see what it is. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I want to see this so bad.
True story.
It is a true story.
We're worried about her sanity.
Gargantuan seven-storied structure with no apparent rhyme or reason. Each maze of halls more confusing than the next.
It's under never-ending construction. It is built on the orders of a grieving widow.
Sarah Winchester is the majority shareholder of the Winchester Repeating Arms Company.
You know, and if any horror film, this one has the most
worried about her sanity, Dr. Price.
Built up reason to have it.
Oh, gotcha, yeah.
Do you believe in ghosts, Doctor?
I do not believe in anything I cannot see or study.
Feel it in the air, in the walls.
This spirit has a power we've not seen before.
It has found us.
You know, I often wondered if the reason so many ghosts were drawn to that home is just kind of the intricate makeup of it. Mm. You know, the thought of playing games, especially the demons portion of it.
Did it say 500 rooms?
Yeah, it had 500 rooms. She built little bitty rooms, doors to nowhere.
Stairs that lead nowhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, for those of you that are watching that may not know the Winchester House, this is just an outstanding home.
You can still visit it.
You can still visit it. I think they do. I think they stopped doing night tours because it was so dangerous. Mm-hmm. They were doing like overnight ghost tours, but people were getting like attacked, scratched, or you have to sign like a waiver, I think, to go in now. But yeah, there were staircases that go to nowhere, doors that open up to nothing, or in the closets, or
you open a door and then it's just a brick wall or whatever. Yeah,
and it was built by, if anybody doesn't know, Winchester is a gun product, one of the most famous guns across America, probably. I think it was once known as America's Gun. And the reason they thought the house was so haunted was because the guns killed a lot of people. Mm-hmm. And they thought the spirits of these guns were starting to infect the home. But again, that doesn't explain why do demons all of a sudden start coming. But I think if you make a playground like that, of rooms that go to nowhere and doors that go to nothing, you kind of set yourself up for that type of mechanism.
Well, it's an architectural anomaly, too. I mean, no master building plan. They built on it ceaselessly for 38 years.
But I mean, she wanted it built that weird way, didn't she?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, so why?
It used to be a normal house. She started closing off some of the doors to some place, like started building brick walls into some doors because they started having apparitions. Started showing up in the house, and then I think, quote me if I'm wrong, I think her husband actually died, and like Mr. Winchester himself either committed suicide or it was like an unknown death, and so she was very convinced that it was spirits or people that had died from his gun products that killed him.
Might be a lot of dead bodies there.
Yeah, so she started having some of the doors and walls like knocked out and made a door there because she was trying to get these ghosts to not be able to know where she was at in the house. And then it just became kind of a crazed obsession to keep remodeling this home adding more things to it.
Mm-hmm. Oh. So maybe her drive was to, mitigate, corral, or satisfy, or please the ghosts with this endless construction. I don't know.
Oh, cool. We can speculate all day.
My friend, actually, Kim Giammarco, is actually watching our show right now, and she actually enlightened me that they have closed down the house, but they do a Friday the 13th candlelight night tour only on Friday the 13th.
Oh, because that's totally not asking for trouble.
Yeah, really.
There's one coming up in April.
So we should all get together and go do that someday.
Right. Hey, we showed us what book you're reading there, Ms. Oh,
I did.
Yeah.
No, that's a plant. It's a plant. It's totally a plant.
It was planted on me, I swear. Well, there's this awesome book in front of me. I was looking through it. I didn't know I was going to be put on the spot.
But hold it up. We want to see it.
Okay, so it's called Fetish, Fashion, Sex, and Power by Valerie Steele.
Woo.
You know, she's a strong, empowering woman with a last name of Steele.
Mm-hmm.
I see how this got planted on me now, reading the background of this. But Valerie Steele is a kinky dressing what Anne Rice is to vampires.
All right.
An interpreter of desires beyond our ken, she deals in riveting stuff the way the culture talks dirty, most of the time without noticing through clothes. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if you can see this, but...
Oh, hey!
This is all... Oh, it's on there.
That is amazing!
It's on there. She's got some latex.
Yeah. All right, that book
actually,
right there.
It looks pretty cool.
I don't know if I should show you, but there's like boobs and a lady with a strap on.
All right, cool.
There's some awesome.
So it's thank you, Rain. You can keep looking, but I just wanted to make sure, and it just said it there on lower thirds. But we got Mike and Rain here from Vampire Court of Dallas.
Sir.
Yeah, and we're very glad to have you guys here. Oh, we'll talk about your big event. We're coming up. We will talk about that big event.
No, it's all good. But I'm having fun.
I think we got one more cool trailer, maybe two or three more trailers or movie previews that I definitely wanted to get in and just kind of get your feedback on too. So this one is. We'll probably play about half of it. You'll get a feel. The Damned, one of my favorite bands, are kind of gone back to goth. And this is their brand new song, just released. Kind of get a flavor there of that song, brand new single from The Damned. Rain, could you dance to this?
Oh, hell yeah, I could.
I agree, man. I think they've done a good job at producing it well, and it's something you would hear, you know, at a goth club or such, but it's really, you know, they're really kind of a straight punk band, but they really have a goth vein in them.
Well, I like that it's kind of pointing to the resurgence of cyberpunk. In terms of music and literature and movies.
And imagery.
Oh, yeah. It's got a big Philip K. Dick, kind of Stanislaw Lem vibe to it, where it's kind of a dystopian look at what's going to happen.
And really, the song is timely. We are standing on the edge of tomorrow. We are. I mean, the decisions our generation makes right now about our future, our country, our ecology, our environment, you know, will be, you know, affecting so many tomorrows, right? I don't know if I said that eloquently. But
I'm much more fatalistic than you, I think. I think it's either going to end up like Blade Runner or Road Warrior, one of the two. Which you've got the leather at home. You've got the jacket. We're prepared.
Yeah, and I've got a mini SUV, so maybe Road Warrior would be all right.
Yeah.
I need to mount the machine guns on top.
Oh, yeah. We'll get some nice like steel plates for the side of it.
We have a Mustang. We could probably put it on some...
Battle van.
You can make a battle Mustang.
That is a nice Mustang parked out in the parking lot there. Yeah.
It's a vampire mobile.
Double guns on it.
Hey, so I don't know if do we have one or two more trailers? Yeah, just throw them in there. All right, this one this is my band called Tankard. They're from Germany, of course. Thrash metal. Just had to do this.
Name like Tankard. They just have to be from Germany, don't they?
Of course. So look at this. So Rain, she reminds me of you, and she's the girl in the rock video.
Nice.
But so the song is, of course,
she's telling my spirit animal. That girl stole everything. I screamed, I cried.
This is amazing.
I wish my hair was just as thick. It's trying to cheat ya. It's trying to trick ya.
And the Corpsepaint. The song is a girl called Cerveza. Okay, so I think, Rain, if I have it right, he has a girl come over, and she drinks all his beer, and then he's pissed. I think that's the storyline of the songs.
I think so.
And then she disappears on him. Yeah.
You know, that sounds like a pretty average German song. Mm-hmm.
Shows up, steals your beer. Disappears.
So, all right, so I just got to give hails and shout out to Tankard because they were one of the big four of German thrash that really emerged in late 80s, early 90s, you know, and I just like them a lot.
That's awesome.
I actually have a phone call scheduled with them for in the middle of this week, but we're still trying to work out some details. So I'm hoping that maybe next show I'll have like a recording with the lead singer from Tankard.
I'm going to teach you like the best catchphrase for a German.
What is it?
Das einen unen kaufen.
Okay, is it rude? Because I hope it
is. Just call me an asshole.
No. If I said it right, if I remember from my days in staying in Munich, Germany, to be a little bit of a funny bastard, it means I left an empty suitcase.
Okay.
And it's actually the background story behind it is whenever you go into Germany, some of the things that they say there, if we see it in America, people would freak out. Here in America, you say, I cut the cheese, or I've left some hot air, whenever you're talking about farting. That means I left an empty suitcase, which to Germans, that means you farted and walked away.
Mm-hmm.
Crop dusted the whole place. And,
no kidding.
But they told me that on a train, and my German was like, oh my God, who left an empty suitcase? Bomb. And
right. Oh, God.
I come to find out sooner or later as my German friend explained
very
it to me.
Very interesting, right? So did you live in Munich for a while?
I studied abroad there for 2-3 weeks.
What was your name?
Yeah. Well, oh, I got it.
Dann muss das weiter uns scheiße.
All right. So, yeah, that's Tankard. Now, look. Tankard started out as a serious thrash band, and their songs were about nuclear war and evil forthcoming. Now, they're just fun to sing about beer. Every album is about beer.
Well,
every song is about beer.
There's beer gardens everywhere in Germany, and you get more than your pint.
Yeah, a lot bigger. All right. Now, okay, so we had a few other things lined up. I don't know if we have any more videos. Yeah, if so, we're just going to put them in right now. We'll talk. Everything I promise you is interesting.
Bonheur à chaque fois de retourner sur cette côte. Oh, regardez là-bas, ces cueilleurs de moules. Oh, comme c'est pittoresque. Oh.
La glycine, elle a pris 2 mètres.
Tout pousse, André. Tout pousse.
Ah, et mon petit frère, comment va-t-il? Jamais je ne m'habituerai à la beauté de ce paysage, jamais.
Papa, vous venez tous les ans.
Et toi, tu t'appelles comment?
Malou.
C'est ici que cette personne aurait disparu, chef.
Ça commence à sentir roussi, là, hein?
Bon, les personnes ont disparu dans la baie?
C'est terrifiant, André!
Y'a rien à craindre, enfin! Allons! La police est à pied d'œuvre maintenant!
Ah, vous trouvez quelque chose? Quoi? Ouais, je comprends pas, qu'est-ce que t'es dit? À tout de l'eau!
C'est une affaire très mystérieuse! Sans cadavre!
Nous protégerait, n'est-ce pas, Malout?
Oh les cœurs, oh les cœurs!
Des grands animaux.
Des gens bizarres.
Un doigt de Wissoki.
Et en blanc! Un infomane, un nudiste et des disparus. Dans toute cette histoire, il y a une providence.
Ah!
Ceux qui sont sauvés et les autres.
Okay, so that movie is called Slack Bay, which looks totally, totally wild and madcap. And I think all the best films really are made over in Europe. I do. And so recommend Slack Bay.
What's amazed me, I think the past 2-3 years, a lot of the independent Cannes films are starting to become a lot more mainstream and a lot more accepted for their artistic contributions and just plain entertaining. Have you seen previews for Death of Stalin yet?
Nope.
I want to see that. It comes out in March, but it's a dark comedy about when Stalin passed away and the scramble for power.
Neat.
It's a great, great movie.
We support dark comedy.
Well, when he showed me the preview, it kind of has a educated and glorious bastard feel to it.
Yes.
Gotcha.
You would love it.
Inglorious Bastard. Yeah. Very good. And, you know, earlier this week, Janie Slash and I went and saw Mom and Dad. Now, this is a movie with Nick Cage.
Hmm.
And
he's still getting work?
Very funny.
Okay.
Okay. I see where you're going, but yeah. All right. So Nick Cage and his wife, they and all the other adults start killing their children. They're not zombies. They just start killing him because something like switches in every adult's brain to where they realize, I really hate my kids, and then just start killing him. And that's what this movie's about. It's rated R. There is some gore, and it's intense in parts. Mom and Dad. Can you believe that?
Hmm.
It's a zombie movie, only they're not zombies. They're regular people who they're going through a midlife crisis, kind of, and think,
that face,
you know,
is
I really
magical.
Don't like – there we go. I really don't like my kids. You know, I think it was almost as if the author of this movie, the writer, heard a parent say, I'm going to kill you. And then took that and just ran with it and made a whole film based on it. And you know what? It held my interest and I just got into it. I give it high marks, man.
To give that a look.
I think my parents said that to me several times growing up. I'm glad
See?
They never followed.
There you go.
This is what happens when it becomes real.
That's why I don't create more offspring.
So in the movie, there's a scene with a newborn.
Oh no!
And I'm just going to leave it at that.
Oh no!
Nice. They don't show. Okay, I'm just going to leave it. Okay. Nicolas Cage is in this movie.
Uh-oh, do you have a
video? No, we're not gonna show that scene.
I am right. Waiting for Dallas Baptist Church to get a hold of that. It is gonna be so much fun.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, Nick Cage wants to murder his children and you know what? They kinda leave it open for a sequel, you know.
Are they gonna have more kids?
I can see the headline now. Liberal Hollywood wants to kill your kids.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. There you go. But it's a dark comedy. It's a dark comedy, guys. It really is. So, I don't know. I like that. All right.
Oh, that face is glorious. I love it.
Yeah, look at that. That's Nick Cage right there.
You're having way too much fun.
That is method acting right there.
Yeah, were you implying that he overacts a little bit? Is that what you're saying?
I like all of his movies. Thank you very much.
Method.
Okay. Right. I think he's a fabulous actor, and I know he bought like a pyramid and Nola, but you know, I think I could really get along with this guy.
Yeah. Do you mean the gravestone?
Yeah.
Is that Nick Cage?
Isn't that?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
Yeah. It is. Yeah. Right. And I think it's what Metairie Cemetery. I think Kim can.
Yeah, Kim's still watching. Kim can let us know.
All right. So look. So okay. That movie recommended. Mm-hmm. We saw a preview for what is it? Mary and the Witch Flower, and Slack Bay, and Tanker, Kristeen Young, Freak Show. You know, recommended as well. But we got some flyers to show about various things and stuff
coming up.
And one of them, I don't know what order we'll have these in. There was one that is The Damned, and their album is called Evil Spirits.
Nice.
Brand new release. There it is.
Oh, awesome.
So that song we listened to, Standing on the Edge of Tomorrow, that goth singe that Brain can dance to.
Yeah, it's probably going to be one of my next routines.
Yeah.
Good. Oh, good. Okay. Yeah, is...
she promised it here.
Is this album. Now, so, yeah, they're starting out a 2018 tour in England, and Kristeen Young, our friend who will be on the show in 2 weeks, will be opening for them in London. And then also in 2 weeks, I don't know if I told you guys this, we'll be speaking with Bruce Campbell from... Bruce Campbell. Bruce Campbell will be...
Wait, you're going to have him on the radio show?
Yeah, he'll be on our show. Not live in the studio. We'll be talking to him via telephone. And Janie Slash will be handling that interview. So that's in 2 weeks. Yeah, Bruce Campbell.
Oh my gosh, definitely check
I'm
in.
Super
is this
excited.
Doesn't he have like a trivia night coming up?
He does, yes. Now we have a flyer for it. I don't know if we can pop it up, but it's called Last Fan Standing. It's February 23rd. It's at Gas Monkey Live. There it is right there. Last Fan Standing, live trivia contest for nerd culture know-it-alls, hosted by BC. Mm-hmm. Now, so when we have him on our show on the 11th, I'm going to ask him, what trivia should we be brushing up on? And really, you know, how does it work? Do you stand the whole night? And then if you're the last one standing, you win? You know, so anyways, yeah. So we got Bruce. He's scheduled in 2 weeks.
I think
in between the three of us, I think we could get a team going. It's, yeah.
Cool.
We would conquer all.
February 23rd at Gas Monkey Live is Last Fan Standing with Bruce Campbell himself. And you know what? We love Bruce. We love Gas Monkey Live. I was there on Friday.
I'm sorry to interrupt.
Sure.
But can I just say that Bruce Campbell's autobiography is like one of the greatest books ever?
Hmm.
I don't know if y'all have read it.
I have not.
What?
It seriously, like, it's one of the best books I've ever read. And I read probably 2 or 3 books a month. Mm-hmm. And his autobiography is just...
Hail to the Chin, that one? Or... he's written like 2 and then Make Love the Bruce Campbell Way.
It's
and
the first one that he ever wrote.
Yeah.
So,
okay. Cool. Gotcha.
So great. It's so good.
Well, I've heard that he writes very fluid and very funny, and that it's, you know, it's easy to read and grab a hold of.
He speaks to my soul.
Yeah. So of course, you know, he's been in a lot of movies, but people just think of him from Evil Dead and Evil Dead 2 and such. You know?
An Army of Darkness.
Right. But yeah, good old Bruce. Confessions of a B movie actor? Is that it?
If Chins Could Kill.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. So
if
great.
Chins Could Kill.
If Chins Could Kill.
Mm-hmm. And we're already giving him promotional hits. There you go.
Come on, Bruce. Yeah, I'm trying
Come
to talk.
Come on the show in person.
I'm trying to talk to get him in here, you know, because he'll be in town on the 23rd. So just stop by, man.
Tell him the show's in a bunker and it's armored.
Yeah,
just in case.
We're down in the bunker.
This is where I want to be when the zombie apocalypse
happens.
There you
go.
So, for clarification, we are part of On Air Media, and we record from professional studios in Dallas, Texas, in the bunker because we're underground. Yes,
and
we support
of zombies.
We support underground. We support B movies. We support underground bands, and we support those people who are honest with their numbers. Yeah. All right, now. We got some other flyers. I think there's a cute picture of Kristeen Young. I think there's something about your event coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, there she is. Yeah, she'll be on the show, too, the same day as Bruce Campbell.
Nice. You're going to have a jam-packed show that night.
Jam-packed. February 11th.
We'll call it Valentine's Show.
You're totally crushing. We can tell. Totally crushing.
So, here's the other trivia about Kristeen Young. She told me that she actually sings on three backup vocals on three damn songs on their new album.
What? Yeah.
She has a song about the devil, too. So.
Yeah.
I mean, she's a fan. She got an in, boss.
The truth comes out.
Look, can I tell you that Dave Grohl's her drummer?
What?
Dude.
Yeah, part of the time. I don't know if you have it in the folder, but we had this video of the a music video that she did. And I forget the title of the song, but it was from the Late Late Show. The Late Late Show, it was Kristeen Young, the Late Late Show, and I forget the name of the song, but it was their live band, and there's Dave Grohl, man. Yeah. I guess they're buds, so he drums for her sometimes. So
how does this guy have all of this time to be
able
to...
I know, he's everywhere.
He's Dave Grohl.
I think there's like four clones of this guy just kind of flying around.
So, Kristeen... on this show on the 11th, she's an American singer, but somehow she's very European, cosmopolitan as well.
And did you find it?
And all right, here we go. Yeah, let's watch for a second. You tell me if this is Dave Grohl. They'll cut to him. They'll cut to him in a second. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That is totally Dave Grohl.
That's even the guitarist that's with.
With Dave.
Grohl,
with Foo Fighters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he did a lot of stuff with Nirvana. That's him right there. Yeah.
Oh snap!
What's his name?
The Unknown Hero, guys. Yeah.
But you know who I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's totally him.
It's his go-to guy.
Well, I think at this point in his career, he could pretty much do whatever he wants.
Yeah. So look, Kristeen Young kicks ass.
Fantastic.
Nice.
And you know what? A lot of people don't know about her. And, you know, I'm hoping that maybe our show in 2 weeks will change that. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. I hope so, man. But
fantastic.
If she ever...
Pat Smear. Her. That's his name.
Okay. Pat Smear.
Yeah.
If she goes on tour around America and they're in Dallas, I got to just tell her, hey, come in the studio. Come on.
Yeah.
Just get in here.
Bring Dave.
We want to make sure you really exist.
Bring Dave.
Bring Dave.
Bring Dave.
We want to make sure you're not a bot. You know,
Rain
we support
will,
real
Rain
people.
Camp outside the studio if that's that's the case.
I don't know. I think she's cool. So, Kristeen Young. All right. So, we've got some other flyers and events coming up. And any of those you want to pop up there, Jedi, he's fine. So, Jedi's our engineer tonight, filling in for Ziggy, who's doing his stand-up comedy in Waco tonight.
Nice.
Yeah. It's called Skip the Pro Bowl Show at a comedy stage in
snap! That's our event!
Okay, so you got to pause on this one. Yeah, so the event is February 11th.
Yeah.
Mike, Rain, take it over.
That sounds like a very eventful night because, I mean, you got some great people coming on your radio show, which you guys can watch the radio show, then to our event!
Yes!
On the 11th. So, Mike, you want to talk a little bit about the charity aspect?
All right. For a while now, we've kind of been doing our yearly Bleeding Hearts Ball and have kind of an anti-Valentine's Day theme, either on Valentine's Day or right before. And this year, we chose February 11th for our Bleeding Hearts Ball, second year in a row. And we wanted to choose somebody that kind of goes in with that theme, but also somebody that's local and could really use the help. And we reached out to the Heart of Gold Foundation, which puts on several fundraising events in favor of kids with medical needs. And what they do is they donate to summer camps to have medical facilities and medical support on hand. And that will allow these kids to go out and have a traditional summer camp fun experience, play some sports, get some sun, and run around and just be kids. And to me, it was off the charts, the support that we had. It was absolutely unanimous when we went to vote, and I'm more than happy to lend our support to such a great
cause. Man, that's great. So you'll be, I guess, taking up donations there, yes. Et cetera. Okay.
We have monetary donations that we can take at the event, as well as your money if you decide to donate any money there. We are selling raffle tickets for some major prize options.
Yes.
That will be raffled off on the stage that night.
We have over $2,000 in prizes. Raffle tickets are $10 a piece. And yes, we will take cash or credit card donations for raffle tickets. Or if you're a good person and just wanting to donate for the sake of donating, then we're more than happy to take that and put that toward the cause.
Yeah, last year we raised like $790 worth of money towards the American Heart Institute. So this year we feel with the following and the amount of group, our goal is to raise $1,000.
Good.
Yes. So definitely want to get people out, get supportive of the event, and it's all for charity and a good cause. 100%. We don't pocket any of the money. It's all going straight 100% to the charity.
All right. So if I was a novice, I would see that and think to myself, look, it's a ball. Do I have to dress? Is there a certain dress for it? And so.
Well, we kind of bill it as a formal event, which of course it's black and gold this year. However, I mean, if standard goth attire, goth club attire is perfectly welcomed, we have people that have actually come straight over from Reno's and from a metal show to come out and to donate and lend their support. I'm not going to turn away anybody that wants to lend their time, their energy, and their money to a good cause charity like ours. However, I mean, if you're wanting to take part in the theme of the night, I have no issue posting pictures and putting you on social media and showing how awesome you are for participating and lending to the theme and the atmosphere.
And not only that, is if you don't want to donate your money like to a raffle ticket, we also have Frankie with Rock and Soul will be giving massages at the event, and she's giving 100% of her massage money back to the charity. And we also have a couple of other vendors that are doing the same thing, that they are giving a portion of what they make back to the charity. So if the raffle itself is not for you, we have vendors and other things you can do, as well as we'll also have some strolling magicians just walking around doing close-up magic that they're going to be taking tips for, and we'll be donating their tips. They offer to give them back to us as well.
Yes, and we have the awesome Kim Giammarco, who's doing some fortune telling and reading some cards.
Yeah.
So if
intuitive readings.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, excellent.
She is awesome for lending her time to this event, and all proceeds are donated to the cause as well.
So come and dance a night away. It's at The Church, also known as The Lizard Lounge, on Swiss Avenue in Dallas on February 11th. That's a Sunday night, and it's all for charity.
Yeah, and it's going to be – we try and make the event a little bit different than a lot of your other events. You see performers, but this is just going to be a night of celebrating talent and performance. Mm-hmm. So we have two aerialists and a sideshow performer and the Southern Gentleman Juggler, Artie Dodger, is going to be there well. Yeah. So this is not going to be like a burlesque event or anything like that. We just want everyone to come out, have fun, dance, and enjoy talent. That's why we have the magicians and acts that you may not see every day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe we can ask the DJ to include some Damned standing on the edge of tomorrow.
I think we could.
Or some Kristeen Young, you know, and then I'll go get on the dance floor and go crazy with Mike. There we go. Yeah,
I'm in. I dance with you.
So, all right. Well, this sounds great, man. So, Bleeding Hearts Ball, February 11th, and this is your second annual, and it's all for charity.
Sure.
And you've donated that as your charity. Mm-hmm. What? I'm sorry. What are they called again?
The Heart of Gold Foundation of North Texas.
Yeah, VIP is already sold out. But we will be selling general admission tickets at the door.
Yes, it's $10, 21 and up.
And last year you had hundreds of people at this.
Yeah, event. We had 600 attendees last year. Yes.
And interestingly,
get there
enough,
early.
For you, our original cash donation count, not counting card donations or credit donations, was $666 even.
See? It was meant to be.
So,
right, Kat?
There you go.
Woo. Don't you like when that happens?
Oh, yeah.
It was hilarious. We had to count it like three times. Like, did this just happen?
All right. Well, we are the non-award-winning Corpsepaint show, and we like it that way because we like staying in the underground.
I'm going to nominate you for an award just because you said that.
Okay, fair enough. Mm-hmm. But look, who wants to be on the above ground where corporate ties your hands and restricts you and tells you you can't say this or do that and show this, whatever? Mm-hmm. You know, we like our little show underground, and we'll bring interesting people to you that you need to know about, like Kristeen Young, right? Dave Grohl drums for her. So, all right.
If Dave approves, then I think everybody should approve.
All right. Totally cool. Totally cool. Bruce Campbell and Kristeen Young in 2 weeks. Now, next week is February 4th. Janie Slash will be back. She's talking about Women in Horror Month. February is Women in Horror Month. So we talk particularly about directors and actresses in horror. And sort of like that, yeah, where the women take the lead role. And there's more movies like that, Rain, where the protagonist is the woman. Rather than just being the victim running through the woods,
yeah, right.
You know, it's the women who are the protagonists or the attackers or the powerful roles.
That's fantastic. You know,
man, that's what 2018 should be, is women empowerment. That's what we believe. We do. And we say that every time also at our burlesque show, that it's all about women empowerment. I don't
Heck
know.
Yeah.
So if we she's all killing know. Me, does that mean I get the nude scene?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you're going to be nude in a tent. And then she's going to, I don't know, you're going to be just, I don't know, thinking about things.
Running through rain.
Yeah, and then.
Think
yeah.
about that peanut butter. Yeah.
We all know that if there were more, if there were more women in political office, this country would be better off, wouldn't it?
Yes.
So let's work in that regard. All right. What else we got to cover, guys?
Get your massages from Rock and Soul. I got mine booked this Saturday, so you guys should too.
Well, hold on. You're getting one this Saturday?
I am getting one this Saturday from her. Okay. I've already had one.
Okay, yeah, good. She's fantastic. We need to do that. And you know, I've talked about her on this show before too, and we actually showed her logo.
What?
Rock and Soul Wellness.
Cool.
Rock and Soul Wellness. You can find it on Facebook. Rock and Soul Wellness.
She comes to you. There's no excuse. Get
that massage. She'll bring her massage table to you. So she's licensed massage therapist. So. Okay, so I don't think there's anything left yet that I sent to our engineering team, and I think we covered it all. And so, very great to have you guys here in the studio.
Oh, thank you for having us
in the bunker.
I can't think of anything else.
Yeah.
Yep. February 11th.
If you want to come out to a Vampire Court of Dallas event, we do have public meetups every first Sunday of the month. Our next one is Saturday the 3rd, though.
Yes, Super Bowl Sunday.
Because of Super Bowl Sunday.
Yeah, what can you do?
Totally fine. Look, you don't have to have fangs on or anything.
Nope. You can be human. We won't bite.
Come as you are, blue jeans and t-shirt. See what we're about. If you don't like what you see or anything else, tell us. We're very open. We want to be driven by the city of Dallas, the city of Fort Worth, and let kind of people decide what kind of organization they want.
We're up to 42 members now, too.
Yes.
That's
our brand new group picture by Aoife Haney Photography, Yukon Studio.
That's a great picture. You guys look great, and you know, I recognize some of these faces here too. And so obviously all these wonderfully wonderful, handsome and gorgeous people will be at your event on February 11th.
They will. Come out and say hi to them.
But it is not a formal event. People don't need to think that they need a dress in black and white.
But it's actively encouraged, though.
It's encouraged. We want to try and keep kind of, because it's also Mardi Gras weekend, so we're kind of keeping with like a circus formal.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So come dressed in a mask if you want. Come dressed in a ball gown. It's really your interpretation. We want to keep it classy, but if you can't, we're not going to turn people away.
Yeah. And props to Ginger Man Dallas for letting us shoot that photo and kind of close down their upstairs and take over.
Yeah.
They're wonderful people, and they've been absolutely encouraging of what we do in terms of our charity work and community support.
Same with, I know there's a bunch of vampires watching this because I've been seeing you guys watching from New Orleans, Denver, and everything. So you guys better give the Corpsepaint show some likes as well and support small
real likes.
Shows. Real likes and follow.
So, all right. So really, and just kind of wrap this up, you would describe your group as a social organization out to do good.
Yes.
Help the community, And so you therefore have these events and choose a charity.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And it's just for the more maybe dark-minded, not so much, these other fancy groups that get together and they're all suit and tie. You guys are the fun version of it.
Yep.
Yes.
We're beer, barbecue, no bullshit.
Yeah. We don't do drama or any of that. We are open-minded people doing good for the sake of doing good. And as of this year, we are one of the few, the proud, the 100% charitable donation organizations in the country. 100% of all of our proceeds and benefits from any of our events, any of our online donations, go to the causes that we choose collectively.
These are our officers. We have some really pretty people on our court, just saying.
They're so gorgeous.
You don't have to be, everyone's gorgeous to join the court. Come on.
That's great, yeah.
Very good. Some of our members. Well,
very good.
Lame.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Kim. That's greatness.
No, we're very proud to have such a very supportive group. So.
Yes.
We say thanks to you guys, Dallas Vampire Society, for being here. Dallas Vampire Court, I'm sorry.
Sure.
No. For being here and just enlivening this show. We appreciate it a lot.
Yeah. Oh, and actually, talking back on being 100% donations, is we're actually on Amazon Smile now. So Amazon Smile is the exact same thing as Amazon. So if you guys purchase things from Amazon on a daily basis, just go to Amazon Smile and order stuff. And like, I think 10% of what, or 5% of your, whatever you purchase goes back to our charity to go to future events.
Okay. So let's be clear on this because I remember it came up before. There's no increase on the price of the item you're ordering.
Nope.
It's every single product Amazon offers.
Yep.
And instead of going to Amazon.com, you go to, is it Amazon.smile.com? Something like that?
I think it's smile.amazon.com.
Okay. Yes.
And you could always just Google Amazon
there
Smile
we go.
And it'll pop up immediately.
And so you're listed as an actual charity organization
Sir?
There.
We are.
And you are a 503C. You are a nonprofit. You are an actual charity.
Sir.
And so when or before you order your item, you have to just designate Dallas Vampire Court.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And any active charitable 501 organization will go, is on their listings.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you want part of your proceeds to go to Heart of Gold Foundation, for example,
or even the Red Cross,
or the Red Cross, or whoever,
you
can select that and a portion of your purchase will go to their choice. And they receive a check, I believe it's once a quarter for the proceeds of that.
Yeah,
we actually got a pretty nice check.
No kidding. That's great.
A lot of our members used it during the holidays.
Yeah, exactly. That's great. And it costs nothing.
Nope.
Absolutely nothing.
For the person buying their products.
Nope. No increases.
It's any charity you want to choose, they're all listed there. You just do the drop down and find it.
The tax you're already paying actually goes to charity instead.
Yes.
See, this is a little hidden feature of Amazon that a lot of people don't realize. Do you know also if you have Amazon Prime, you get a lot of freebies? Sometimes people don't realize, like ebooks. Mm-hmm. You can download a whole bunch of ebooks if you're an Amazon Prime person at no additional cost.
I did not know that.
Just a little tip.
Pretty cool.
Hey, thanks a bunch, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us.
Remember,
making it up like a radio show.
Remember, go code orange. Maybe they'll win something tonight. But if they don't, it's fine. Up for the Grammy.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Thanks, you guys. And thanks to our engineer, Jetta.
Thanks, Jetta.
Take care.
Are you with the Republic or the new? It's a very
Come
serious
on.
Question.
You should already know the answer to that.
But I do want to say for the record, we miss our friend Ziggy. No offense.
Hey, listen. Yeah. No offense taken. Ziggy is the man.
And I miss Janie Slash. In here running butter.
Yeah.
Not butter. Oh my gosh.
She adds a lot. She sits right there and she looks at me sometimes, and sometimes I get the evil eye and sometimes I don't. She's always adding something. All right, you guys, we love you and thanks a bunch. See you next week.
Bye.
Yeah, the Corpsepaint Show. Every Sunday we're here live. We're going to give you 90 minutes of live, great, irreverent shit. And also just talk about Satan and talk about movies and talk about metal and talk about Jenny Slash's weekly dose of horror.
Yeah. Texas Friday Night Weekend. I am here with Dee Wallace. Don't stare at my boobs all the time.
Sure. I do get comments from occasionally religious fanatics.
I have seen people stopping down walking.
Wag their finger
at me for a ring sign. The Corpsepaint Show rules!